of the 18th and offered me his apartment that he had empty. I told him he'd have to go through the office through you.
Kevin is right back here remembering that, and again, she's the one that set up and went through, as you will remember, each of you, a lot of this and that. Would you like to see? What about this? We don't have a bed. Can you get us one? All of those things were taken care of by Kevin, and it really facilitated you folks getting in and feeling somewhat comfortable. You can't feel at home because it isn't your home, but at least you felt comfortable.
And there were groups of clubs and that type of thing who responded to many various various ways that was very, very helpful.
Sure, absolutely.
I'm sure too, like with myself, was the people in the unit that I was in were so, they'd stop and talk to you and ask how you're doing, how things are going. I had a wonderful neighbor.
Friendly.
I had a neighbor that was just fantastic. And they really took us to heart.
The one thing, I come from the Midwest, and the one thing that I miss out here is porches. Because where I lived, you had porches, and people would walk by and you'd say, hello, neighbor. You know, the traditional thought of Midwest, hi, neighbor type of stuff. I started seeing that. Just what you said, Mary Ann, Connie, you were shaking your head, Vera. Yeah. When each of you moved into your places and Kevin and I would be around to see how things were going on, that's what I started noticing. It was a concern for someone that had lost something, and how can I help? And that's huge. That's huge, and you only get that from a community that cares. Let me ask, as we start to wind down just a little bit, what is important to you now that may not have been important to you before? Your thoughts?
Well, right now, I think it's life means more than anything. Material stuff, some of it may mean a lot, but it's gone. It can be replaced, most of it, in some way. But lives, that's, and they all got out but one. And that was very important. And it is now. It's true that once my place is completely furnished, I'm going to have pictures of everything on a tape and given to my niece to keep in her house.
There you go.
In case something happens.
Let's do that. Thank you so much. And we'll get right back to that. Let's put another mental note in the grab bag. Please remember, folks, those of you that are out there, and these people remember it, in order for your insurance company to be able to take care and repair and replace the items that were lost, you need to have a record of them. Not only just a receipt, but an individual catalog of a photograph or a digital DVD that will allow you to be able to say, this is what I had in my apartment. So another thing to put into the bag. Thank you, Vi, for that.
All right now, everything I bought, I kept the paperwork that came with it. I put the model number, I put the receipt, and the date I bought it. It's all right there.
You're ready to go. Let me go back to a very sad point, but something that needs to be said. One person, as Vi mentioned, lost their life in this fire. These folks have been talking over the past several minutes regarding things, but the loss of life is, and as Vi said, the most important thing now is her life and the life of everybody at that table. To kind of close this down, is there anything that, and we'd like to take this one at a time, because this is the close down of this. It'll give you a little time to think. What would you like to say to the people in the audience about what happened to you personally? Any thoughts that you might have, and we're going to do this individually, about what you would like these people to know that you hope they never have to go through what you have been through in that 10-month period. Vera, you're up next.
Oh, I'm up next. Okay. devastating, for one thing. I had open heart surgery a week, 3 months before that happened. And I wasn't even up to par.
No.
But I was lucky I got out safe. That was the most important thing. As far as the incidental other stuff, they can all be replaced. That I had given my children a lot of my photos, and they had it on their computers.
Thank you very much. That brings to mind something, and I'm sorry for interrupting here, but this is key for the people in the audience.
Yep.
You were the person I remember talking to now that said, fortunately for you, you had given away many things, not saving them, and let's be honest, many people say, when I die, my grandchildren are going to get this. Vi, go ahead. Looks like you got a thought.
I had two. I had a whole big collection of Hummels. I had sent them all back east to my family. They all could have them. I had a set of jewelry that was special because I bought one of the things from my brother, and I gave it to his daughter, the whole set that would match, so that she'd have it. And I am so thankful that I had gotten given that all away already, because every time I go home, I take a few items and giving it to people so that I wouldn't, if something happened to me, I wanted to make sure they got these things, and it paid off.
Fantastic. Thank you both, ladies. Elaine, you're next up.
I'd just like to, again, repeat the amount of paperwork is incredible. Even if you have your great records, which we had in a safe, the safe may be fireproof, but it's not waterproof.
Mine was.
When the fire, make sure your safe, if that's what you're intending on using, is because, and the files just become a big, a massive pile of paper mache. You can't even peel the layers off to find your birth certificate, marriage license, whatever.
And you're referring to the water damage once the water has seeped into the safe.
Yes.
So make sure it's both fireproof.
Fire and water sealed.
Terrific, Elaine. A great point. Thank you for that. Dorothy?
Yeah, we lost almost everything except the safes and papers. A lot of pictures due to thank you for somebody. And all Chad's, most of his guitars and instruments were saved. Some were damaged, was unfixable. But the worst of everything I've lost was videotaping of my grandkids. My daughter's wedding, my sister's wedding, like over 20-some years of taping. House, we play music. Bluegrass music. We go to people's houses and we would always play. You know, that can never be replaced now. My son was actually, Ralph was saved a few things off my old videos of little pieces of here and there. But that was the worst. Everything else I can deal with except that. That was like I couldn't deal with.
Dorothy, let's make a mental note for the people in the audience. If you have very treasured and valuable old Super 8 movies, let's go back to the 50s and 60s. If you have VHS tapes, please make sure you get them transferred onto another system and put somewhere other than your own house.
I had hundreds of tapes, hundreds.
Lost.
A family.
Lost.
Lost forever. Nobody else had a copy.
Thank you for sharing that. Very important.
Otherwise, we're okay.
Everybody at the table is saying, hey, we're here today.
Yeah.
Connie, up next. Thank you, Dorothy.
Well, I did a lot of, I got rid of a lot of things whenever I go see my daughter. And one thing I do think everybody needed and everybody didn't have, because I wasn't thinking of it, you need an advocate, which Bayad and Dorothy have. A lot of people did that, but you just, you need someone who is an advocate for you and cares about you and can think for you, because you aren't thinking that well, you know, and having an advocate is great, and I never thought of it for myself, but I've sure learned that, especially, and when you